We are at Edison High School in Northeast Minneapolis.
We're working with the class to create small curriculum units based on stormwater best management practices that we can find throughout our watershed. And we're picking a few particular sites that are found at schools so that these units then can be integrated into the classroom so that the kids have a place-based learning opportunity.
We worked with their organization to create curriculum models with our students who are teachers that they then could take into their classroom.
We have teachers literally from kindergarten through 12th grade.
All of this south side of the parking lot drains down into these pervious pavers.
It's the perfect way to start introducing these really important topics to students.
We wanted to look at sustainability and how we improve our water quality.
Not only do they get a great overview and a glance into stormwater maintenance, but then we can continue this education moving forward with the youth.
A lot of times there's a disconnect for students about where they live. And to realize that the little things they do, okay, it might not impact somebody across the world, but it impacts what's happening here. It makes them realize that they need to have the skills to be able to think through problems that could be happening in their own backyard.
At the front drop box and in the storage tank, you're gonna have pollutants that will settle out of it and start to build up on the bottom of those things.
This was some place that we could look at, how are we impacting our environment? And now how do I take that as a teacher and bring that to my students and show them, actually there are things you can do as a 12-year-old that will change the environment in positive ways.
We say that we do our best work through partnership. To be able to expand our mission in that way, where other people are kind of taking on that importance of the role of teaching others about stormwater, is how we can do our best work.
The power of the model is that it brings together many different people looking through one or two or a few issues through many different lenses.
I'm just looking at this going, is there a way that I can have students engineer a water flow sensor? And can they do the math to figure that out, and how can I apply that to then something local around St. Louis Park High School?
All of this area ended up in the Mississippi River. And using the geometry of the existing ravine, we could calculate those erosive forces of that water.
They're looking at the math and science behind it as well, and you know, how can their students start to use those components, those measurements, and look at the design?
Really doing like an introduction to rivers in general, like, what are rivers? Like, why do they matter? Why do we care? Like, how do they work?
The water will come through, hit that cheese grater.
Between the lessons and the visit,
clean water would proceed.
And the education they received, I think they walked away saying, yeah, I can do this.
And the unit plan that I make, I can bring not only into my classroom, but like to the whole school potentially. So I'm excited about that.
We'll share those with Mississippi Watershed so that they have educational materials to share with other teachers who come through their program.
The students will learn about important stormwater features not only on their site, but then they can become stewards of water management in the future.